I'm Katie Anderson, and we're at Johns Hopkins University in Baltimore, Maryland. I study random gene expression in the fly eye. So these are examples of, these are fly retinas that have been dissected and stained for the different proteins, rhodopsin 3 and 4. So, and in this green here, this is staining each unit eye. So flies, you might know a lot of insects have many eyes as part of one eye. And so the fly eye has 800 unit eyes, and each one of these green blobs is essentially one eye. Most of gene expression that occurs in your body and in most living things is highly regulated. There are things telling your cells what to do and what proteins to make. But in this case, we don't know what it is. It seems that each cell in the fly eye makes a random decision to express one protein or the other, and that essentially determines their fate. The cells that have random gene expression in the fly eye are the ones that detect different wavelengths of light. They're called the R7 cell. They express either rhodopsin 3 or rhodopsin 4, and these proteins are what detect different wavelengths of UV light. And so that's kind of homologous to, in a human, we have different cones that detect red, green, and blue light. And they're randomly distributed in the eye, like in this mosaic, and it's the same for the UV detecting cells on the fly. So I actually grew up in Maryland. My parents and my siblings, no one's in science. For a long time, I was pre-med, and probably until like midway through college, I realized I just didn't want to do that. It wasn't for me. But that's really the only science I have in my family is that my grandfather was a doctor. And so for a long time, I thought that that's what I wanted to do. Then in high school, I took an AP biology course, and I just loved it. And I couldn't stop asking questions, and I just wanted to know everything. When I went to college, it was pretty obvious that I was going to study biology. The question was what I was going to do with it. Throughout my undergrad career, I had a bunch of different research opportunities, and I realized that no matter what I do, I just get so attached to the project. Like, I just have to figure out why. And I realized that if I feel that way about any project that I'm doing in any discipline, then this is probably what I should be doing. I really like to know why, and I'm never really satisfied with the present knowledge that we have. I want to know more, and I can't stand not understanding how something works. And this is something that no one in the world understands. No one knows how this process is happening in the fly eye or the human eye for that matter. And I think that it's really exciting to be working on something that no one knows and you're gonna figure it out. Hey.
Hello.
Do you have scope time today?
No. Because they take like a
week. Oh. So your primer's the one with the fluorescent tag?
Yeah.
I wonder if I should do that. The best advice is to just get experience, to try it out. It's always a plus if you get experience in high school, but I definitely didn't have any, and you just have to seek it out in your undergrad career while you're in college. But yeah, really just try different things and find what you like, and maybe research is for you, and maybe it's not, and maybe med school is more your route, but I think the key to finding out if research is really what you want to do, and if it is, to really get to that point, you just need experience.